Hey everyone, Irit here, and today I have a new scrapbooking process video for you. This is the layout I will be creating, and it is part of Scrap Madness. So Laura Alberts and Miranda Weber are doing a video again, a video a day in March, and I'm the guest designer for today. I'll post all the relevant links below, and that's always fun, right? To get tons of scrappy videos. So I am totally scrapping my stash today, and I'm using this gorgeous, gorgeous Felicity Jane kit. This is an older kit designed by my friend Suze Fish, and I just wish I could get such a kit again, because it was just so special and so pretty and different from everything that I have pretty much. So I got myself a ton of these, and I've made many, many layouts with them, and I was happy to use it again. I still have some stuff for a few more layouts. So this was just a lot of fun, and it's always good to use up our stash, right? So I don't have a ton of embellishments left from this kit, so I decided to make some of my own, and I created those by using the stamp set that came with this kit. I'm sorry this is no longer available, but obviously you can just grab your favorite stuff from your stash. You know, that one collection that you really, really loved and you bought a ton of and you still have some leftovers. So grab that and let's make a layout. I'm just piling up some layers. I have this cute photo of my eldest girl, Ella, and the colors worked so well with the colors of this kit. So just going back to the stamp set, I used some of the stamps to create my custom embellishment. I used them on my on the pattern papers from this collection and just stamped it in black ink. Obviously, you can do something that I love to do is to emboss in white and then watercolor it. You could do that and create your own embellishments, but here I kept it really simple, and it really works. That kind of black and white look works with this kit and this layout. So the papers are going to be mostly this kind of powder periwinkle blue with some soft pink and then lots of black and white pops. I'm distressing the edges. I think it just adds a lot of texture. Especially when I'm creating a layout that I know I don't have a ton of very dimensional embellishments. I mean, I will be adding those also here. I will dive into my stash and grab some of those. Don't you worry. But I didn't know exactly where this was going when I started. And this is a great way to add a lot of texture without actually having to add any type of special products. So I just distressed the edges of all of these. And yeah, I'm just trimming this down to a 12 by 12 because I think it was a little bit bigger. And just trying to arrange my layers, making sure that I make it in an order that makes sense. So trying to kind of vary the colors, you know, layer a pink paper over the blue and then again blue and pink. So just making sure there's a variety as I layer them and not like all the pink papers are together and then all the blue papers are together, just scattering things around. And here this piece was a little bit too small, so I cheated and my camera is moving and I stretched it to make it look like it was a bigger piece than it already was, than it actually was. So that's what I'm doing here. And just, you know, piling those layers behind my photo so I have a good starting point to use my embellishments. I'm also using some, I think these are just scraps of some white cardstock. And I wanted to add it because I thought it would brighten a little bit my background and also echo that white that I have in the top layers, because in those back layers I just have that pink and blue, and I wanted to just add some white there. It just, I feel like it really lightens the whole thing, even though my colors are light, but I do really like having light colors in all my layers. So what I want to do is add my title, and I'm trying to make it work. That's one of the challenges I feel when you have a lot of layers, that sometimes it's hard to add a title in a way that, you know, that it doesn't look super, super busy. When there are like all these layers underneath your title, sometimes it looks really busy. So I'm trying to come up here with some sort of an arrangement that works. And I'm just using some letter stickers from previous Felicity Jane kits, really diving into my stash. And she makes some gorgeous, gorgeous letter stickers. I especially love anything puffy. So I created this cute title. And I think it says focus on the happy days. And I think just that day, I was having some challenges with my almost teenage daughter. So it was nice to scrap this a little bit older photo and kind of, you know, not dwell on the annoying things and remember the good stuff also. So yeah, I'm going to add my title here, and I cut this circle from one of the pattern papers, and I layered the sticker on it. You can see at the end there are some close-up shots, so you can take a good look at all the detail in this. But this was fun to make, and I think I made it work so that you can easily read the title and it doesn't look too busy. I tried to cover most of the areas where the pattern papers overlap because those tend to distract the eye. They just pull your eye there, and not in a good way. It's not like a nice embellishment. It's just an awkward place where a lot of pattern papers meet. So I tried to cover those and have the title, you know, be in a way that is easy to read. I also added that big cupcake that I fussy cut from one of the pattern papers. And yeah, I really like how that looks. So now I'm just adding some outline with a black pen. I really felt like I needed just a little bit of definition to the papers. It looks better, I feel, and a little bit more intentional, and you can kind of, yeah, you can see the layers better. That's how I feel about it. And I thought it just looks nice. It somehow looks a bit more intentional and a little less, I don't know, I just layered a bunch of papers together. So now we can get on with the embellishing. And you see, again, I don't even know if that ampersand makes it to the end, but I think the reason I added it is because it covers some of that awkward area where a lot of pattern papers meet. So that's why I put it right there. And I think now I was just trying to make it work and maybe make a longer title, but I don't think that that works. So I will end up covering that area with some other embellishments. But yeah, that's just me kind of, you know, problem solving and troubleshooting as I go, because I don't like to plan everything ahead. So I just finish one thing, you know, layering my pattern papers, and then I have to fix all the issues that arise from that decision that I didn't think through. So I'm just looking through my stuff and seeing what I can use. I'm looking through my stash of older Felicity Jane kits, and I really wanted to use this cute little, what is this? It's kind of like a ribbon, but it's very dimensional. It has these cute little blobs. I don't know how to call these. I don't know how these are called. Forgive me. I wouldn't even know how to call them in my own language, let alone in English. So my own language, meaning my native language, my mother's tongue. I don't know. I'm very tongue-tied today. I'm really sorry, but my mother's tongue is Hebrew and English is my second language. So, yeah, I don't know how that thing is called, but you can leave me a comment and let me know. For me, it's like a ribbon type of thing. I don't know. I'm sure there's a good word for it. So, I just wanted to show you that I layered some of these stamped cupcakes on these. What are these? These are circles. You can see them on the screen. It's a pack of circles made from tissue paper. And I used some foam adhesive and put a little cupcake on top of those circles. It's a very subtle effect because the circles that I used are very light in color, but it does give another layer, another texture. So it's one of those little things that I feel make a difference. And yeah, I also stamped some clouds, so I'm going to try and add those and kind of build my own little embellishment clusters. I struggled a little bit with where to put stuff, but in the end, it all works out. It's all good, and it was fun to make. So I skipped ahead just a little bit because I felt this part of the video was getting a bit repetitive, just trying to move things around and find embellishments that work. So you can see what's going on. What changed here? I found this little doily somewhere in my stash and I added it to the right side next to my title. I thought that looked really nice with that added texture. On that bottom cluster next to my journaling, I also added a flare button that had the same pattern as one of my pattern papers. So that's a good tip, try to search for repeating patterns if you have those in your embellishments. Sometimes embellishments will have also the same patterns as the pattern paper in that collection. So try and search for that. On that top right cluster, left, sorry, to the left of my photo, I'm building there a little vertical thing going on. So I used that beautiful heart was a part of the sticker sheet that came with this kit. And then I have another one of those stamped cupcakes, and I found this cute ribbon in my stash. I think it was from Cheeky Studio, I want to say. I hope I got that name right. It's Tuesday Hubbard's store. So that cute little polka dot ribbon, I love it, and it worked really well for what I had going on here. And I don't know, I just felt like I needed some sort of extra detail because I felt like all my layered pattern papers were a little bit simple, especially because I used the largest papers are not pattern papers. They're just one color. So I just added some more detail. I added some white splatters. And after I thought I was done with this layout, I actually took another look in my stash and decided to add a few more things, which you will see just now in the final photos. I used this beautiful white trim that I bought at Michael's and some puffy butterflies. And that's it. I loved making this. I hope you will enjoy this month of videos, and thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day. Bye.